What is the matter with sodium?
I think it's about the... well, the electrons?
Did someone say electrons?
What's going on? Sodium is behaving strangely around... well, you know what. Oh, the you know what with the you know who.
I'm confused. You guys talking about Lord Voldemort?
No, no, we were discussing electrons.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, what is going on here?
He's turning into a vampire. He's after our electrons.
Oh, come on. It's probably just an ionic or covalent bond.
But there are no nonmetals around.
Right. In an ionic bond, a nonmetal, which is highly electronegative, attracts the metal's outer shell electrons to complete its own. Both atoms get to have a full outer electron shell.
They also get a charge, right?
Correct. The nonmetal gains electrons and becomes negatively charged, while the metal loses electrons and becomes positively charged. What about the covalent bond?
If the two nonmetals are the same,
they share electrons equally. If one is more electronegative, one has a stronger pull and the bond becomes polarized.
Let's just add a nonmetal. Here, sodium, give me your outer shell electrons.
No, no, not my precious. We must keep it safe.
You forgot to say Gollum.
Maybe it's time to seek professional help.
You can't mean... Neon. Yeah, he's the worst.
No worries. I was talking about Silver.
I take it back. Silver is the worst.
I would rather ask Neon.
I don't think we have a choice.
Fine.
But let us keep the Hogwarts drama to a minimum.
Who disturbs the Silver Wizard?
We seek wisdom for sodium acting strangely.
Behold! You stand before the Silver Wizard!
We know. The Silver Wizard is fond of using the third person.
How can the Silver... how can I be of assistance to you?
Whoa, usually takes a lot longer to get to the first person. Nice work, Oxygen.
I have my moments.
Can you tell us what's happening to Sodium?
He acts up whenever we mention... you know what?
Kryptonite?
Not even close.
Lord Voldemort!
But why does everybody keep saying that?
Frankly, just to mess with you.
So what's the deal with Sodium? Has he joined a cult?
Indeed. It appears that our young friend has joined the lattice.
I love the lattice. Goes great with the tomatis. I see now. I believe he's talking about a metallic lattice. Metallic? That doesn't sound very tasty at all. A lattice is simply a repeating structure. In this case, a network of metallic bonds between sodium atoms.
Without any nonmetals? Is that normal?
It is an abomination.
I'm standing right here.
Now behold!
Excuse me? You already said behold? Twice?
Three times. Yeah, it isn't dramatic anymore.
A valid concern. Behold! Evil incarnate! Mount Sodium!
There's a drama. Nailed it.
Evil incarnate? It's just a block of sodium.
What's Mount Sodium even made of?
Evil!
Yeah, but besides that...
perhaps I can explain. Instead of a single ionic or covalent bond, metals can form a network of weaker bonds that collectively make a stable structure. In the structure, electrons form a sort of sea of electrons that can move freely within the lattice.
Lattice. Is that why metals are such good conductors?
Exactly. When presented with an electric potential, you can conduct electricity by easily moving electrons from one side to another. The metallic lattice also gives metals their other properties, such as ductility and malleability.
How come?
Individual atoms can rearrange themselves within the lattice, while maintaining its structure of metallic bonds. This means that a metal can bend and stretch before snapping when an external force is applied.
Gotcha. The way you describe it, it does sound a bit evil. Thanks for clearing that up.
Did you miss the part where I said that sodium was not evil?
Anyone else feeling hungry? I could go for some of that sodium lettuce salad.
That does sound delicious.
But without the evil, right, Oxygen?
Sodium is just a metallic element. It is neither good nor evil.
but it could be really bad for your blood pressure.
Sodium? Who's sodding you on? Anybody know a good ritual or chant to dispel evil from salad? Oh, here we go again.
I know just the spell. Hold this lattice, and do not worry, it is quite cool to the touch. What do you see?
One ring to rule them all, a valence ring to bond them, atomic forces ring them all, and in the lattice bind them. One ring to rule them all, a valence ring to bond them.
Ever wanted to be part of something elemental? Step into our sodium circle, where we promise a salty twist to your mundane existence. Like, comment, and subscribe to become part of the lattice and conduct-
Sodium? Are you being creepy again?
No. Maybe? Yes?
You were just supposed to ask our viewers to support our channel and tune in for the next episode.
Yeah, do that too.
But definitely join the lattice.
See you next time.